Gecko versus Lotus teams. Our project is based on biomimicry, which means be inspired by nature in order to develop innovative technologies. In particular, we focused on two main topics. One is adhesion, and the other one is anti-adhesion in nature. So the Gecko team, which is the first to present, they focused on anti-adhesion in nature. So they studied different kind of anti-adhesion from animals and nature, and they tried to implement this on artificial surfaces like soles in order to study safety for footwear. Whereas the other team, Lotus, we studied super hydrophobic surfaces, so anti-adhesion in nature, which means super hydrophobicity and self-cleaning properties of lotus leaf, in order to reproduce these features on artificial manufacts and to produce, to be applied in the sector of household appliances. So in particular, we focus on fridges. So these topics are really, the project is research driven, so research is an important part, and actually this field is really innovative. So we had to build the knowledge ourselves, and we had to perform experiments and simulations in collaboration with Pugno Lab, and then we also collaborated with external companies such as Vibram and Indesit. Okay, this is all. I'll give the word to my colleagues of Gecko team.
Hello, we are the Gecko team, and our goal was to study the super-adhesion properties in order to develop a new concept, footwear sole, in collaboration with Vibram. As a research-driven project, we have divided our work into three main phases. During the first one, we have analyzed the whole problem, trying to identify the stakeholders and the requirements, and we studied the state of the art in the footwear sole field. Then, after that, we have understood the critical issue about safety soles. We performed some in-depth study about some aspects of adhesion in order to improve adhesion in soles. And then, during the last phase, thanks to trade-off and analysis, we found out the most suitable solution, and we produced some prototypes at Vibram, and we tested them. We have divided our stakeholders into three groups according to the requirements they have on our project. The first ones are the Alta Scuola Politecnica and Pugno Lab, who require us to work in a multidisciplinary and innovative project and to make research with high quality standards. Then, according to the Eurostat data, we discovered that slips are the second leading cause of injuries at work, and we quantified the huge impact that they have on the companies, especially in the building and factory fields, and on the state corporations that are devoted to insurance, such as INAIL in Italy. So just a little improvement in the safety sole could lead to huge money savings and less injuries at work. And last, thanks to the collaboration with Vibram, we have learned which are the specific sole requirements. And we have considered the technical and economic requirements. We decided not to consider the design requirements because our project was just at the research phase. So obviously, a sole must have the highest slip resistance as possible, but at the same time, it should have a good behavior in the static to dynamic transition, because in this way, people can have a feedback of the incident slip. We have to consider the problem of durability, because a sole should be wear resistant, and its properties must be constant over time and not vary with abrasion or contamination. And last, we must remember that the sole is just a little part of a whole product, and its cost must remain little, just a few euros per pair, and the technology that we decide to use must be reproducible on a mass scale production.
In order to understand how we can improve the performance of the sole, we have to study how we walk and why we sleep. So, the action of walking is based on the exchange of forces, and in this figure we can see H and V that are the components of the active force, while H prime and V prime are the components of the reaction force. A slip occurs when the requested friction is greater than the available one. So, in order to improve the slipping resistance of our sole, we have to increase H prime. These forces can be split into three terms. The first one is the adhesion, that is the ability of the material of the sole to create chemical bonds with the ground. Then there is the hysteresis, that is the additional contribution due to the deformation of the material. And then the last term is the shape factor that takes into account the fact that the sole is not flat. So starting from this observation and studying also the existing solution, we can highlight five key features that are common among the safety shoes. And the first one is the low heel to assure the maximum stability. Then the sole should be flexible in order so that the wearer has a better feeling of the condition of the ground. Then the sole should be flat in order to maximize the contact area, but it should also present a tread pattern, that is the presence of channel and ridge that allow the sole to contact the ground also if liquids or contaminants are present. And finally, the sole should be made of high friction materials because we want a high static coefficient of friction in order to make the slipping condition harder to be reached, and also a high dynamic coefficient of friction in order to avoid that the slipping velocity increases sharply after the detachment. So we can see the application of all this concept in this example, that is the sole Montagna Block by Vibram. In particular, we can see the compromise between the request of a large area contact and the presence of channel that make the sole self-cleaning. We can also observe the presence of some insert that whose shape is optimized in order to be effective in any direction of movement. And we can also observe that all the elements that are present in the sole are designed so that their functionality is constant also even if the wear modifies their geometry. So going back to our key feature, we can consider the first three as constraints for our sole, while the second one and the real parameter on which we can act in order to improve the performance. So in our research, we focus mainly on these two topics, and we also consider some new innovative concept, and we evaluate their applicability in the field of safety shoes. So the first element that we studied is the geometry of lugs and ridge. We organized our research in several steps. We started from the bibliographic study on single and multiple peeling, in particular considering the relationship between the peeling angle and the peeling force. Then we perform a parametric analysis of the formulas, and we design an experimental setup that we employed for our laboratory experiments in order to validate the theory. And for this experiment, we have employed an adhesive tape because it is a quite simple system that contains within itself the element of complexity that is the deformation of the material. As a result of our experiment, we can see that the pulling force varies sensibly with the peeling angle, and that the crucial element for peeling force is the scale of the geometry. So we can conclude that it could be possible to define an ideal geometry for the thread pattern.
As the second research aspect, we studied a biological hierarchical surface in terms of adhesion of that kind of a surface on different surfaces with different roughness. We decided to study the common cockroaches, Blatta orientalis, because they present a dry contact system. And after bibliographic research, we built a centrifugal experimental machine with a video camera that allowed us to study the specimen behavior and to identify the exact velocity and force in order to understand which is the detachment force of the animal. Then, with some microscopic analysis, we studied the structure of the leg. And we performed a roughness analysis, and thanks to a correlation, we found out that there is a maximum adhesion when the claw tip dimension is equal to the asperity diameter of the surface, that it is usually very little. And this work was submitted as an article to an international journal.
in order to create a new concept sole with high performances also on wet and dirty floor, we decided to focus our attention on natural surfaces. We are inspired from nature and on two key parameters of these surfaces, which are the safe cleaning and the wettability. The wettability depends on surface roughness, in particular its micro and nano hierarchical structure, as we can see in the photo of the water streeters' legs. To understand the effect of the hierarchy on the wettability of the surface, we performed many experiments. We carried out many experiments with the cabbage leaf because it has a similar structure to the water streeter's legs. And then we measure the contact angle and the sliding angle because we want to know which side is hydrophobic and which one is self-cleaning. Further to this experiment, the theoretical model of the hierarchical contact angle confirms this result, and so we obtain the results that the hierarchy is very important and has a very influence on the wettability of a surface.
Finally, we drew inspiration by nature also by studying suction cups. These devices are used, for example, by octopuses, which control actively and directly the internal pressure of the cup in order to obtain adhesion to onto an interest surface. We focused on the industrial application of the suction cups, which is instead activated by an externally imposed force, which causes some air in containing it to be expelled in order to obtain the desired adhesion. We modeled the behavior of the cup by introducing a linear elastic approximation of its behavior, and as a result, from the theoretical point of view, we obtain a theoretical optimal radius for the cup, which is dependent on the constitutive material for the cup, on its geometry, and on on the externally imposable force. Therefore, in order to decide which of the options we studied in the research phase was the most suitable for our application, we performed a trade-off analysis. We focused on four different options, which are advanced thread pattern suction cups, bio-inspired hierarchical surfaces, and improved material. And in order to judge them, we selected four main criteria, which are performance development, durability, short-term feasibility, and costs for each of the options. We decided not to give each of them the same importance, the same weight, but instead we preferred, for example, performance improvement, being this still at a research phase. Thus, we gave a mark from 1 to 5 to each of our option in each of the selected criteria, and as a result, the highest mark was obtained by the suction cups, mostly because their overall good adaptment for all of the criteria. While, for example, we obtain a good behavior for performance improvement in bio-inspired hierarchical surface, but a bad judgment for what concerns durability or costs, for example. Finally, so for the solution, we firstly built some different models of suction cap soles. We constructed them with different materials and different cap densities. And we tested these soles with the Vibram tester team, using two different typologies of tests. The first one is a homemade test by Vibram, which allows to measure the static coefficient of friction. It is a versatile scheme because it allows to change easily the condition in which the sole is tested, and it is human controlled. Therefore, we could also be able to obtain qualitative information about the sole, also for its wearability and its sensation for the wearer. The other test is an internationally recognized test by SATRA, which allows instead to measure the dynamic coefficient of friction, and it is a machine-controlled one. For the results, we obtain good results with the PVC caps, and especially we obtain a new record for the static coefficient on friction on the, smoothest surfaces, while we obtain also good SATRA results, which were close to safety requirements defined by SATRA for safety footwear. But we also obtained a bad transition with between static and dynamic behavior of the of the sole, and especially we obtained also bad feeling for wearers during the tests. These negative issues were given mainly by the large dimension of the cap. Therefore, we decided to rescale the problem to a lower dimension by confronting macro suction cap with micro suction caps.
Okay, so we try to rescale our micro suction caps, and we try to mimic their effect in order to produce a porous sole. We want our solution is producing this porous sole, and we collaborate with Vibram. The materials we needed to produce this sole are rubber and many chemical additives, such as silica as a filler, and then we have to add a blowing agent to the compound to obtain the correct compound, the correct sole compound. We use Vibram facilities, and we want to obtain three types of the sole molds, because varying the different quantity of blowing agent, we obtain these three types of sole with different density. And the lightest is the blue one. The sole compound with the highest density is the red one. We want our aim is to verify if there is this suction caps effect and its variation with porosity and density. So we analyze our samples, and then we take images with the scanning electron microscope, and we processed them with the computer software in order to obtain an estimate of the percentage of the surface covered by the pores. Then for the we obtained the results expected, so that the we obtained that the higher porosity we can say the highest porosity with the sole that is the lightest one, so with the lower density. Then we tested the sole, our porous sole, our prototypes, with the same test we have done with the suction cap sole, and we extended the surfaces where we use to test the sole. In particular, we see that the coefficient of friction decreases with increasing the porosity of the sole. And we see also that there is a bad behavior with the SATRA. And from this result, we can say that the pores don't behave like a real suction caps. In conclusion, we can say that we have a remarkable result. Our remarkable result is that we adopt an innovative approach in the field of adhesion. And in the field of adhesion, and because we are inspired by nature, we perform an high quality research, and so we developed the prototypes collaborating with an international leader in sole manufacturing, and we tested them to obtain reliable results. In conclusion, we can say that the requirements for the sole are that we have to walk in safety in wet and dirty floor condition, and the production process of the sole has to be very feasible. We satisfy these requirements thinking about a solution, and we think about the solution that passed from the macro to micro, so from producing suction cap sole to porous sole. We obtained that we need further study on other key parameters because we are focused only on porosity. Maybe we can improve our research and studying other parameters like such as the material of the sole. And then we think that the micro suction caps for adhesion of the sole is not a field that we can abandon because we think that it's possible to improve the fabrication process and so to realize a very adhesive sole. Thank you for your attention.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Let me start to introduce you our group, Gecko's versus Lotus Team B, or Team Lotus. Let me start to showing you a video about the amazing performance of a lotus leaf. So as we should see in the video, the drops impact on the lotus surface and then they don't wet the surface. Also, the drops fly away from the surface very quickly with a very low tilt angle. So the lotus leaf exhibits extraordinary properties in terms of super hydrophobic effect, as shown in the image on the left side, and also exhibit other properties such as self-cleaning properties. So drops rolling on the surface of the lotus leaf are able to remove dirt, as shown in the image on the right side. Also, the lotus leaf exhibits anti-adhesive properties, so drops impacting on the surface just bounce off from the surface without leaving any residue on the surface. So our object is to take inspiration from nature to design lotus-like surfaces with such amazing properties. So the aim of our project is studying cyber-hydrophobic surfaces and also self-cleaning surfaces for household appliances. And we selected the application as a fridge. So along with our partner, industrial and academic partner like Indesit and Politecnico in Torino, we developed this solution. So we can divide our project in three different steps. So first we started studying the physics of the interaction between water drops and super hydrophobic surfaces, building strong foundation, reliable and strong foundation necessary to investigate the next step. So the next step is define rules and design rules and guidelines for designing proper artificial super hydrophobic surfaces that could be reliably used in industrial application. Also, the last part is about designing a possible refrigerator layout that fully exploits the properties of these kind of surfaces. So the most common hydrophobic surface we have to see every day is the Teflon technology used in frying pan, for example. This kind of hydrophobicity, which is low, is obtained by chemically coating the surface of the frying pan. Then, as we should see, the performance of this surface are really lower compared to the performances provided by the lotus leaf, as shown by in the video. So the idea of scientists in this field is try to reproduce these kind of effects in artificial surfaces. We have here some examples, and also the pillar-like surface we use in simulation in the center. So let me give you a metric to evaluate superhydrophobic surfaces. So the contact angle is the only metric that could truly represent this kind of behavior. So if we increase the surface roughness or just increase the density of microsparities on the surface that are the feature that makes the lotus leaf such a nice hydrophobic surface, we'll have higher contact angle, which means a highly superhydrophobic behavior, as shown in the plot. Increased density, higher contact angle. We have two examples here, a pearl drop with high contact angle that roll off from the surface very easily, like in the lotus, and also we have an impala drop with low contact angle that don't roll off very quickly from the surface.
And so we have to move from the background knowledge to the further step in the innovation process that is bringing the lotus effect in your life, in your house, in your fridge. And so what does happen in the fridge? You can try to image a drop impact in the surfaces, then the drop rolls on the shelves, and finally we can also image to be able to force the motion of this drop with some advanced technology. And so, as I was saying, we try to imagine how the drop move, how the drop, what is the journey of the drop inside the fridge. And so we simplify our complex problem of reproduce the Lotus effect, dividing the work in three work package that deals with impact, roll phases, and then to the technology needed to force the motion of drop. So let's speak about the impact. The journey starts from a housewife spraying some cleaning product or in the fridge, or from a drop that detached from the moisture in the fridge itself. And what's happened next? To discover that, we have to run some numerical simulation to reproduce the scenario of the impact dynamic. And this is a key point that we used an open innovation tool that is OpenFOAM. And in fact, CFD codes, CFD software to run the simulation are very expensive. And without an open innovation approach, as explained in the summer school of 2010, we cannot solve this issue. And there are very different outcomes of the drop impact dynamic on standard surfaces like the Indesit one in the upper left figure, and in respect to an impact on super-adhesive surfaces like the Lotus leaf. Let me show you what happened. That's what's going on. The standard surface remain wet, while the super-adhesive surfaces reject the drop and so can remain dry. But additionally, the surface is not only dry, but can also be cleaned with a super-hydrophobic pattern. And the things work like that. We have a drop impacting the surfaces, and then the dirt particles that are the red one are moved away by the drop itself. So the surface is dry and cleaned. And of course, nothing of these things are possible on standard surfaces. But the life of a drop is not so simple. There are also some traps on the path, and let me say, like in the video game Prince of Persia, if the drop gets impaled, the game is over. That's it, because we have implemented a pillar-like structure, so we have a pillar that are like needles for the drop, and so we have two different outcomes that are pearl drop state and an impalent state, and between these outcomes, between these possibilities, there is a threshold velocity. This velocity is the impact, the velocity with which the drop impacts the surface. And since we think to the needs of our stakeholders, that can be the designer of super-adhesive surfaces, we figure out how this threshold vary in function of key parameter of the surface topology, that are the pillar rate and the pitch distance, that is in fact the distance between adjacent pillars. So in this graph, we can identify two zones that a designer could use as well, that are an pear drop zone, an correct project zone, and a forbidden zone, that is where the drop is impaled. So you have to imagine a designer that has his surfaces, so he know the height of his or pillars and the pitch of his or pillars, and enter in this graph and can understand if his design is correct or wrong. And the other important thing can be noticed on these, that are a saturation effect in the reaction performance of the surfaces, that are this plateau, and that means that you over a certain value of the height, the performance of the surfaces will not grow anymore. On the other side, mismanufactory in the construction of, in the fabrication of the pillar structure, for example, having a rectangular base instead of a square one, reduce drastically the performance of the surface itself. And finally, some the most part of this result has been presented at the American Physical Society meeting a few weeks ago, sharing our knowledge and bringing the ISP reputation overseas.
The second part of the follow the drop approach is focused on droplet movement along the surfaces in order to analyze possible self-cleaning properties of the surfaces. So the figure and the scheme show us the system we analyze. There is a surface which is inclined and there are some dirty particles. So the idea is that the drop moves along the surfaces and it removes the dirty particle. To pursue this goal, we perform a numerical simulation by OpenFOAM and experiment. And in this case, a specific experimental setup was required. And actually, it was, an interdisciplinary challenge because we have to manufacture it. And this setup requires knowledge from different backgrounds. From those experiments, we found out that two possible movements exist, the rolling and the sliding. And the idea is that according to the kind of movement, the dirty particle can be removed or not. In case of rolling, which is the case of the Lotus leaves, this happens. Where unfortunately, in case of sliding, the particles remain on the surfaces. And unfortunately, this was the case of the Indesit, of the surfaces that Indesit provide us and that we tested in our experiments. From this, we found out that important interaction diagram, which is extremely important to design super hydrophobic self-cleaning surfaces. And the message is that the more the contact angle, the higher the contact angle, which is the surface property, the less influence the inclination angle of the surfaces and the mass, the volume of the droplet it used to remove the dirt particles. The last step was to analyze the collision between the droplet and the dirty particles. And as it is an elastic collision exists, there is a relationship between the mass of the dirty particle that can be removed and the mass of the droplets.
The last step of our follow the drop approach regards the possibility of moving the drop. In fact, from the previous discussion, we know that we have two bad cases. One is the one of impale the drop after the impact on the surface, and the other one is the case when the drop is on a plane surface, and thus it cannot slope null roll. We get from theory that a possible a movement of the droplet is possible thanks to the application of an external voltage. And so we can think of an application of this kind, and of course we need to think about such an application on a larger scale. And when we think of on a larger scale, we need to take into consideration a kind of sandwich design, because at least two electrodes are required in order to move a droplet. And we need to consider the smallest liquid volume we are able to displace, which depends on the maximum distance between the two consequent electrodes. Well, at this point, we know the theory, the background of the Lotus effect, and we need to think how to reproduce it. We have studied three different topologies, the random, the designer made, and the hierarchical one. The hierarchical one is the one that reproduced the Lotus effect, in fact. And we can see that the random one is the cheapest, of course, but it has a low effectiveness. So we think that the designer made, which is the one we have studied, could be a possible solution for industrial application. And when we think at industrial application, we also have to think of the possible stakeholders. We thought about industries and housewives. They both want a cheap and robust product, and these two needs can be translated into the minimization of the shape factor. The minimization of the shape factors means that we want a slow H and a high P. But we know from the previous discussion that in order to have super hydrophobicity, we need exactly the opposite. So a high H and a slow P. Thanks to the Pareto front that we have studied in the spring school, the art of modeling, we are able to find an optimal solution for this trade-off.
So, the research is not all. If we want to have the product marketable, we also have to address feasibility problems. What are the feasibility problems we addressed? Are sustainability, profitability in terms of market analysis, and then if the project addresses social responsibility problems, and then we design a layout for an application. So sustainability is a very complex issue, which involves economic, social, and environmental matters. So does our technology meet all these goals? The answer of this question is yes. Why? Because economics, yes, we meet economics because the design, the technology we studied is an add-on, which means that we do not have to change the production line. We can make this thing on every kind of surface. We just need to add one step in the production line, so we don't have to change all the design. Moreover, the social question, yes, because we are address users' needs, so they don't have to spend much time cleaning the fridge because the fridge is self-cleaning, so they can save time. And moreover, it's more hygienic. And then for environmental and green problems, yes, we meet them because we save resources because it's more rational, the cleaning process, and also we consume less energy because the performance of the fridge is improved. And so we have sustainability. And as for profitability, we also have to the product has to be marketable, it has to be profitable. And so we did a small market analysis considering a cost based on Indesit data and also data on similar technologies. And what did we find? We found that we have a positive NPV. Yes, we have high uncertainty on this result, but the key fact is that this is measurable. We don't have something theoretical. We have something which can be done. And moreover, the most interesting thing is that this technology is a disruptive one. So there is the possibility to actually change the trend of the market, which is a flat one. This would be a savior tonic for the market. So there is a possibility to step change the sales and so change the market. And finally, we also addressed open innovation problems. So if the product is to be on the market, it's something which is going to happen in the future. So in the future, market logics are changing. So we can't think about production and consumption divided, but we have to think about the possibility to have open innovation. We used open foam in our project, so something open, so the collaboration. And in our case, so we found out that there is a possibility to increase the profit by considering open innovation, like in the case of Lego. Finally, the layout.
Okay, there are different ways to implement the technology we address in this project. The simplest one is to replace standard shelves in a fridge with a new super-adhesive shelf that guarantee no frost and self-cleaning capabilities. Another way is to couple super-adhesive shelves with a hydraulic line to accomplish an automatic cleaning circuit that works like this. The drop moves from the water tank, a nozzle spray them on the surface that self-cleaning cell, and finally are collecting with the electrowetting or RL technology in a reservoir. But thinking out of the box, there is, and in some way we draw with the add-on position, we can also reinvent the fridge and propose a kebab-like fashion that works with a central axis and circular shelves that rotate, and so the drop are moved outside by the centrifugal force, and so we again reach self-cleaning capability and an automatic fridge.
Okay. In conclusion, what can we say? We can say that we build a strong research base, so we discover something because we had to build the knowledge ourselves. We developed design guidelines, so something practical in order to take this technology one step further. And also we study feasibility and we designed a possible layout for an application. And then, so the final conclusion is that at this stage we need a final investment and a skill management in order to take this project one step further into the reality, because it's not something theoretical. So we thank you for your attention.